Now, the third application of Gauss theorem, that is, the electric field at a point due to a spherical charge distribution or a uniformly charged spherical shell due to that, what is the field at a point? Now, let us assume a spherical shell of radius r, and if I give an amount of charge q distributed on its surface, let that be considered like this. This is sphere, but I cannot draw the sphere here, therefore it is assumed to be a sphere having a total charge of q distributed uniformly on its surface. Now, due to this charge distribution, if I consider a point outside at a distance r from the center of the spherical charge distribution, such that r, which is greater than capital R. Now, the electric field at this point to be determined using Gauss theorem. For that, we have to consider a Gaussian surface. Now, here the Gaussian surface, if we take the symmetry about the charge distribution and all, we get the Gaussian surface as a sphere of radius small r, which is enclosing the spherical charge distribution. That is, I can consider an imaginary sphere around the spherical charge distribution like this. Now, to get the field here, I consider a very small surface area here of value ds, and its area vector is outward, and the electric field at this point due to the charge distribution is, let it be E, which is normally outward. As you understood, the field lines will be going outward normally. Then, the very small electric flux d phi, which is equal to E dot ds about this small surface. Now, applying Gauss theorem, for this particular surface, I get closed integral E dot ds will be equal to q by epsilon 0, where q is the charge enclosed by the Gaussian surface. Now, here the electric field at this point and all around the spherical Gaussian sphere, at all points, the value of the electric field will be same. The magnitude of the electric field will be same. Therefore, I can take that electric field outside and write it like this, q by epsilon 0. Now, the closed integral ds, that is the total area of the Gaussian surface, that will be equal to 4 pi r square. That is the surface area of the sphere, that will be equal to q by epsilon 0. So that electric field E will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q by r square we get. Now, this is the electric field at this point at a distance small r from the center of the surface, center of the charge distribution. Now, the vector form, as usual, you can write it into vector, unit vector n and all that. But here, a point to be noted is that this equation is similar to the equation that we have already seen for a field due to a point charge at distance r. That means the whole charge distribution here is acting just like a point charge situated at the center for this particular point. That is to be understood. Okay? Now, this field, I can write it as field outside the sphere, that will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into 2 by r square. Now, two more results from this we can obtain, that are What is the field very near to the surface of the sphere, or field on the surface of the charge distribution, and field inside? The two results can be obtained from this one. So if I assume the point very near to the surface, then distance to the point from the center of the sphere will be equal to the radius of the sphere, and therefore field on the surface will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q by r square. You get? Because for this, the small r is equal to capital R mathematically. Without integration from the result itself, we get the right exact point. And if I assume a point inside the spherical charge distribution, let us assume that point will be at distance x from the center. Then, if I assume a symmetric surface, a Gaussian surface, it must be a sphere of radius r, as you know. Now, that Gaussian surface is enclosing actually zero charge, because the whole charge is outside it. So, charge enclosed will be zero, and therefore, electric field inside the spherical charge distribution will be equal to zero, because Q inside the Gaussian surface is zero. You don't have to go for the integration at all. We can assume that value Q to be zero straight away, assuming the Gaussian surface. So, these are the three results we are supposed to understand for the spherical charge distribution. Okay? Now, based on this, one more question you can assume, or one more question you can expect from the board, for the board exam, is that these three results, how we express it in terms of a graph. That graph I am going to draw here. Let us see. This is the graph. And the origin of the graph is the center of the sphere. And this particular distance is the radius of the sphere. And this axis, let us say, the distance from the center, and this is the electric field E. Now, inside the spherical charge distribution, the field is zero. That's from center O to the radius R, just on the surface, up to that the field is zero. That means I can assume the field will be like this up to that. But when you reach just on the surface, what happens is that the electric field will be having a maximum value, that is E, on the surface. And that maximum value will be this one. So that from there, the field value will be jumping to the maximum, straight jump. That this represents E on the surface. And after that, as we go away from again, the value varies like this, that electric field E outside will be inversely proportional to the square of the distance. That is, E outside is inversely proportional to square of the distance, so that the value goes decreasing and goes parallel to the distance axis, because the field becomes zero only at infinity. So this graph is very, very important. You can expect it for the exams. So this graph is enough to understand the variation of electric field due to a charged spherical shell. Now, for entrants, aspirants and all, we can get, or we can assume one more point based on this graph. If we assume a charged conducting sphere, understand, charged conducting solid sphere, the field variation will be exactly the same. Understand that? Very important, charged conducting solid sphere. It's because if I give charges to a solid sphere, conducting sphere, all that charges will be coming out and distributing on its surface. That's the property of a conductor. Charge will not reside inside, it goes and goes up and distributing on the surface uniform. Just because of that, the conducting sphere is appearing to be a chart spherical shell, so that all these three results can be applicable to the conducting spherules. Thank you.